And to help us make sense of today's market movements, we're now joined by Jovis Vistan of AB Capital Securities. Good afternoon, Jovis. Welcome to Market Edge again.
Good afternoon, Stanley.
Yeah, Jovis, we lost a bit of yesterday's gains. That's 0.5% lower than yesterday's close, but still finish above 6,700. What are your impressions of today's trading, aside, of course, from the local bourse tracking Wall Street weakness?
Well, I think, Stanley, the market has started the year very strong. And it's only normal for us to encounter a little bit of correction or profit taking. But overall, I think the momentum is intact for us to remain strong for the rest of the month. If you notice that there are a lot of issues that are beginning to make new 52-week highs,
and I think this is
a testament to the strong economic performance and numbers that have been coming out early this year.
All right. Now, well, today's finish was a bit lower at the PSEI. It's still on an upward bias. What is the new critical support to sustain this rally? What level should we all look out for?
Well, normally when you look at trends, you always have to achieve higher highs and higher lows. And the critical support level that we should not break for us to sustain this short-term uptrend would be around 6,650, based on my recollection. So that support should hold, in my opinion.
All right, so it's 6,650. Now, going back to what you were talking about earlier about reaching 52-week high, as far as prices are concerned, many of these stocks, of course, especially in the index, are in that level. And a lot are also nearing that level, where only a few are oversold. Now, are there specific issues you're expecting to break their high significantly? And maybe perhaps for those nearing oversold levels, which stocks also are you recommending?
Well, in my opinion, if you notice that at the start of the year, the one sector that has been strong has been the mining sector.
Right.
The mining sector, I think, year to date is the best performing sector. And this is largely because of China reopening. That will create stronger demand for both base and precious metals. Gold, in particular, has been very strong, reaching fresh highs along with nickel. So we were expecting more mining issues, perhaps, to continue to trend higher, not necessarily move parabolic, but achieve new 52-week highs. Also, I think, to a certain degree, most of the we like the power in the banking sectors. So most of the blue chips should eventually follow, Stanley. I think we just need more confirmation in terms of the fourth quarter earnings performance and more economic numbers.
All right, Jovis, I'd like you to comment a bit on some developments, interesting developments in the currencies front. The Philippine peso reaching its 54 level, getting stronger against the greenback today, at least intraday, it hit 54.80. What can make this development sustainable?
I think, Stanley, last year, one of the main concerns of fund managers and economic managers is basically the fiscal deficit, the trade deficit, and all of these numbers have been improving lately. So for us to sustain it, I think the investors' confidence on the Philippines is slowly improving. And I think that if you base the latest numbers, like the manufacturing numbers that came out, I think last week, we were actually an outlier, Stanley. We were one of the few economies that managed to show growth in terms of manufacturing, along with, I think, Thailand and Indonesia. Most of the major economies like China and the US and Europe are reporting PMI numbers that are below 50, which show contraction. While in the Philippines, we have been improving. In fact, the ability to generate jobs has been remarkable if you look at our employment numbers also. So most of these numbers are creating a lot of confidence on the Philippines, and the latest trade data also reflects that. In fact, the deficit now for the Philippines trade deficit has been narrowing. So these are good numbers that continue to come in and help build more confidence, not only on the currency front, but also in investments.
And still on the theme, of course, of confidence, government set to embark on another global borrowing through a dollar bond offer to the tune of $1.5 billion, marking the second bond offer under the Marcos administration. And now with its first in just 3 months ago, October 2022. Now, this latest tranche said to have been very well received, Jovis. What makes the offer attractive?
Well, first, I think the timing, Stanley. The yields have been high. Mm-hmm. And these are levels we haven't seen in a while. Mm-hmm. And if you notice, most of the global economies are starting to report that inflation may have already peaked. Mm-hmm. That's the case also for the Philippines last December. Our opinion is that we may have already seen the highest level in terms of annual inflation. So yields may start going down. So investors, I think, want to take advantage of that. The high yields that the Philippines can offer. Mm-hmm. And that high yield attractiveness is also accompanied by a certain degree of confidence, mm-hmm. Or security because of the Philippines' strong fundamentals that we've been talking.
All right. On that note, we thank you so much, Jovis Vistan of AB Capital Securities, for your market guidance today. Have a good day.
Thank you, Stanley.